Well, hi there. Thanks for joining me again. You're probably wondering, now that I just finished up the Santana 22 restoration project for the winter, it's not quite done, but it is put away for the winter. I've got it outside on the side of the driveway right now. Tarped up, closed up for the winter, and we've already had fresh layer of snow on top of the tarp. So now I know you're probably just sitting there wondering, what on earth am I going to do with all my spare time? Well, don't worry, I'm not going to run out of projects. In fact, if a man can't die until he's got all of his projects done, I got a long life ahead of me. So right over here, just over my shoulder, is the CJ7 that I bought just a couple of years ago. I kind of got into this. I'd always wanted a CJ7. I've got a CJ5 outside over there. But I just have always wanted a 7. I wanted the extra wheelbase, a little bit wider, a little bit more room. There'd been times in Moab where I felt like the short wheelbase was just not working so good. So I just always wanted a CJ7. And actually, when I see one, even today, on the road, just a nice original looking CJ7, I love them. So I bought this one off eBay Motors. And to just put it succinctly, that thing was very strategically photographed. It was in California, so I didn't get a chance to look at it before I bought it. I bought it sight unseen off the pictures on the internet. Don't ever do that. It was very strategically photographed. And so when I got it, oh my gosh, it was in rough shape. The thing's got 200,000 miles on it. I think it had the original spark plugs from day one in it. So the engine is in rough shape. Got some other major things that I'm going to walk you through as we kind of start this process off of starting the rebuild. Now, this Jeep has had some attention since I got it. I've done a lot of the interior stuff. I put new seats in it. They were shot. I've got a new cover for it, a new soft top. But again, I've got some issues before we get to that point. So let's go ahead and we'll take a walk around this thing. I'll give you kind of a quick rundown of the major challenges that are ahead of us, and then we'll just roll the sleeves up and get ready to tear into this project for the winter. So this will be this winter's project. If I get it done, I got the CJ7 out there whining and crying for some attention as well. So I'm not going to run out of things to do. So let's do this. Let me go grab the camera down and I'll walk you around. We'll have a look at this thing. Well, if we start to kind of walk around this thing, a couple things I'll point out right away. First is I put these bigger fender flares on here to cover the big old thorn birds here. Jury's out on whether those will survive the cut once we start getting this going. My first pass so far is they cover the tires nicely, and I kind of like them from that perspective. But every time I look at a original well done CJ7 with those little 3-inch rubber things, I really like the looks of the original. So those may stay or they may go, and we don't know yet. So I want to show you a spot on the Jeep that is in pretty good shape. Look closely right there. Perfect. Okay, so that done, let's show you the rest of the thing. Actually, it's not that bad, but it is got some issues. So the garage door is closed. It's a little tough to see from the front, but I think you'll be able to see it back here. So apparently what happened to me, what appears to be, is that this Jeep took a hit in the front on this frame rail here. And what happened is they just jammed the frame rail back about an inch or 3/4 of an inch or something from the other side. So the frame rails are still kind of parallel to each other, but they're not lined up together. So that's causing some problems. So let's let me show you what I'm talking about here. So bear with me for a second. I'm no artist, but I'm going to show you what I'm talking about.
All right, so let's see if I can kind of illustrate what I'm talking about with this frame, just so you can really understand where I'm coming from and why this is kind of a problem. So in a normal environment, I'm going to use a little thing to help me draw straight lines here. So we would have our frame rails would look something like this. So let's go up here. We'll draw one there. Draw another one here. Everything nice and straight. Our cross members line up on the grid lines. Everything's parallel. You got your box, rectangles, whatever. Everything's nice and straight, okay? Here's what I found when I pulled this thing off the truck. So if we take the driver's side frame rail and we draw it out here, we'd say it's about here. But then if we come down here to our passenger side, what we wind up with is more like this. Okay, so we're off a bit. So what happens is, you can see that as we try to do our cross members, they have to be at an angle here. The box of our tub is all skewed, and then the way that these jokers kind of sort of fix this is to keep the axles parallel. When I'm talking about them cutting off the spring hangers, they took the spring hanger that was welded to the frame right here, cut it off, and basically just moved it so that the axle could line back up. So again, what I think happened is, bang, right there, someone hit the front of this frame and just shoved the thing back. And then they just cobbled it back together to make it run true down the road to get the, to keep the axle straight. So it should have been, I think, a pretty straightforward repair. I think it could have been fixed, but this is what we got, and it is what it is. So there's where we're at.
All right, well, as you can see, the manifestation of this crooked frame shows up in a couple of places, one being right here in the corner. So this is the top. The corner is pulled apart, obviously under some stress, and it's a little hard to see. My light's probably not going to work very well, but the corner itself is kind of cracking, and yeah, it's going to be tough to see, but you're going to have to take my word for it. It's falling apart there. It's pulling apart. And you can also see, if we kind of try to go straight down at the side, you can see from here how that side, that corner up there where the tailgate is way forward, and this one's way back. And the whole tailgate is kind of at an angle. I can't really tell if I'm showing it to you very well, but the whole tailgate's at an angle. So again, the passenger side frame rail is easily an inch back from the driver's side frame rail. And, you know, I don't know what kind of a SOB does some beer can fix like that, but if it was the guy I bought this from, and if you ever happen to happen across this internet channel, man, I hope you feel bad about how you hid this when you photographed this thing. This was a pretty bad thing to do. And it was a crappy repair, and you ought to be ashamed of yourself. Okay, well, so I did get some seats in here, as I said. And when I first got this, I pulled the original carpet out, and I bought one of these kind of carpet kits from Four Wheel Parts, I think, and I'm just not really very impressed with the fit of the thing. It doesn't fit very good. It's just kind of loose everywhere, and it's cut all crooked up here. Looks like somebody cut it with a pair of scissors, and it's not wrapped and finished on the firewall up there. It is a little bit on the sides, but not a great fit, honestly, and I'm kind of not too impressed with that. So that may just get sacrificed as we start to kind of clean up the interior. You know, the dash is not in too bad a shape, but we might try to fix that up a little bit. You know, get maybe fill in these holes where the old speakers went, pull those out of there, and maybe, you know, kind of go with a more modern look for the dash here. Trick that out a little bit. But anyway, that's the interior at this point.
Okay, so if we list out our priorities for this Jeep, number one is we got to fix the frame, okay? Number two is trans and transfer case. We got to get those things where they'll at least keep most of the oil on the inside, which they haven't been doing a very good job of. So my thought at this point is replace the transmission, rebuild the transfer case. Got to get them out of there first, and we'll see where we're at. See what kind of surprises we have. We've had a few surprises on this thing. Three is the engine itself. So most likely our vote is going to be just put a new short block in there and put everything back together. In doing a little research with the engine, I'm thinking possibly of going with a fuel injection system. Holley looks like they've got a throttle body kind of fuel injection system that then also ties to a new distributor in coil or electronic ignition system. So some of those issues with bad idling and stalls and so forth that these old 250-58 inline sixes have been kind of famous for have been fixed with that. And I have used those throttle body injection systems before. In fact, I have one on the CJ5 and been pretty happy with them. So fuel injection, and then obviously when we get all that done, then we got to figure out what we're going to do with the body. So if the tub is salvageable, we'll salvage the tub and clean it up. Front fenders, hood, all that stuff's, you know, got some dings in some wear and all that kind of stuff. We'll fix what we can, replace what we can't. And then at the end of the day, we get to do the fun part, which is paint the whole thing and make it look all shiny and new again. And what color? Who knows? If you have any thoughts on color, drop me a comment down there. If you've used the Holley fuel injection replacement for the carburetor on these, also please hit me up and let me know how that went for you. Anything I should be aware of or scared of. And I think the rest of this will be pretty straightforward. You know, we'll have the differentials probably just sealed up, new seals and so forth. But the rest of it, I think, has already, I've done most of the rest of the work. I have seen a couple of other things that we might do. LED lights for taillights and headlights. We'll see how much those cost, if they're worth it. And then we'll be done with our list. So there's the list. Let's go out there now. And next time around you see me, I should be starting to tear into this thing.